In the remote village of Kaubaan, right at the border of Alicia and Ubaybohol, sometimes confused with the identity of residency, lives the Asilos.
Hi, we are the Asilos.
Who are they? What makes them love boxing? How is this possible that a whole family involves in boxing? And how did they reach this achievement? Known as Asilo Brothers, this popularity goes down deep. This is more than just brothers. This is family. This is a family of boxers.
We are the family of boxers.
Mother Asilo is very supportive.
Ako si Siberian Asilo, inahan sa mga bata sa boxer. Suportado kay ko nila.
Father Asilo is an amateur boxer and a trainer.
Ako si Edgardo Asilo, amahan sa mga boxers.
The four Asilo brothers are decorated amateur boxers.
We are brothers.
The two Asilo sisters can also punch.
We are sisters.
The Asilos are farmers, vegetable farmers.
This is our vegetable farm!
This is their main source of livelihood since then. They plant opo, squash, melon, eggplant, and more. They also make a small quantity of charcoal from trimmed branches.
Mabulok mo, babuya.
Hogs and a small chicken. The father Asilo has already retired his amateur boxing career. He doesn't plan to bring boxing to his family. It came with time. It started as a pastime. While at a fiesta after attending his farm,
ya minagsugod sa pag uli na ko gikan sa among garden. Naglingkod ko niya. Wailingaw.
He asked his sons to have a sparring.
Nagkuha ko gusto kasi nina. Tagsaan sila na huputos, ang ilang mga kamot. Niya akong ipa-sparring sila, gagmay pa sila.
A sort of pastime using clothes as gloves. Eventually, after numerous days of just a pastime of punches, they feel the pain of the punches after punches. This means that their punches are becoming fast and heavy. This means they improve.
Yeah. Yabot ang time nga manghilak na sila. Pasabot nga nikusog-kusog na po ng ilang kumo.
So the father borrowed used gloves from his neighbor. These gloves were a collection from Angindolman Club, a known boxing hub before. Though these gloves have different color pairs, it can still be used.
Unto niabot ang time nga nanguwang ko gloves nga dili pud ingon nga bag-o. Nguwam ko dito sa mga among amigo. Napikas nga glove basta lang naa gyud magamit ang mga bata.
With a pair of borrowed gloves, he started his self-made training for his sons, a training he considered inadequate and improper.
Training me nga, natural nga training sa kuha nga, nahibawaan sa niya.
Hungry for more sparring, he organized a small sparring tournament in their village.
Man sigig sparring, manung medtog sparring sa among mga silingan.
And served as his son's first exposure out of family familiarity. But an incident stops him in continuing this unofficial tournament.
Day isa ka higayon nga abot ko kabalaka kay pagtanaw na ko sa glove pag uli na mo huy gani kay nakumot ako ang glove. Na di ay gibutang tagum. Kaya si Ginoo nga wag gyud tayo nga disgrasya.
A needle was found to one of his gloves after a tournament which may cause major injury. Thanks God it didn't. Because of that incident, and because he believes that his sons have the potential to shine from this event, he tried to find ways that his sons would be discovered. He approached the then Vice Mayor Balahay and Barangay Chairman of Kabatang to have his sons be included in the bout list of the boxing tournament they organized at the time. The tournament is, however, full. They then allow him to have his sons fight for each other, not as a contest but as an exhibition, which he without hesitation agreed with the deal. His sons have experienced
niabot ang time nga isa ka nagyod sila ring,
the first ever fight above the ring. Then, at that time, Derwin is 7 years old and Jeremiel is 9 years old. Thereafter, he brings his sons tournaments after tournaments in fiestas. Their first prize won $1 then.
Motong nihan niyo ko nga pwede ba ako lang ni silang unayon o is kanang sparring. Motong ikatawaan pa nga ni ko sa mga tao katong uban nga suko kay sa kuno kong klases pagkaamahan nga akong giunay ang mga bata. Gisparring ibubaw sa ring. Nag akong toyo good na yad nga makasuway lang yun mag-experience ibubaw sa ring kong anak.
In his son's early elementary years, the Asilo brothers reaches amateurs in schools, congressional athletic meet, but loss after loss after loss in the preliminary. After a series of losses, Jerwin, the younger brother, asks his father's permission to leave for ALA, then a prominent boxing training institution.
Nangyo siya na ko nga, kaya mubalihin siya o ALA, dili siya mo training na ko kay sa unang panahon ko ang ALA, mo gini siya ikadlukan sa itong boxer sa gol. Ngayon pinaka the best nga boxer, may silang training.
At a very tender age, his father didn't allow him to leave and told him to give him last one more chance. This time, Jerwin is in his later elementary years. It turns out, they rebound from losses. They even knock out opponent after opponent in the provincial meet and reaches the Sebiraa, the school's regional athletic meet. During their first year in high school, their sports events was unnoticed, leaving them uncoached. A friend, Angelito, helped them of this cause.
Hi, I'm Angelito Impis. I introduced Jerwin Asilo to Mr. Flores.
He approached Ricky Flores, a teacher in the Central High School in Alicia, Bohol, which prompted Flores to accept the job right away, while the father of Asilo was designated as trainer. Father Asilo then still uses his conventional method in the training.
Ang akong gamit nga kagalingong training sa pag-apply sa training sa boxing sa mga bata, ang ako lagi yung kagalingong training. Ang sabot sa akong training nga gamit sa mga bata, kapag yung dili pag yung proper training ang akong gamit, tungkol kayo ako nigamit ang mga oras, time sa pag-relax nila.
Surprisingly, the younger Asilo defeated every opponent after opponent in the meets and stunned regional counterparts to reach his first ever Palarong Pambansa in 2017 in Tagum City, Davao, the highest high school sports competition in the country. Though they reap no colors, the feat to reach this far is an achievement itself. Following the success of Asilo, the Central High School in town, in partnership with a local government unit, institutionalized a boxing club calling all youth in grade school, high school, and out-of-school youth and all those interested to enroll in the training free of charge. They hired 3 trainers, with each trainer overseeing 5 barangay each. With less young people interested to join, the father Asilo brings with him his 3 sons, Jeremiel, Jerwin, and Jericho, to train in the newly organized sports program. Furthermore, to boost and expand the program to wider scope of influence, the local executive pays a monstrous amount to Philippine national team trainers and coaches to conduct a training workshop to selected Central High School teachers and LGU boxing trainers.
Nya nag-seminar na mo taga Cagayan ugatong trainer coach sa Philippine team, head coach sa Philippine team.
The presentation was fulfilling, but it was just a basic guidelines on the training as time budgeted was so limited. The Father Acelo find every possible ways to get a detailed, proper training manual from the Philippine team. After the last day of the workshop, he went straight to Pasalubong shop, almost 100 kilometers away, to buy presents for them in exchange for the manual. His effort paid off, as he has not only received an official training manual, he also received a Philippine team jersey.
Agi seminar nga training namo kay istorya raman na itayong nga makalimot me o yun sa ito nila pagpasabot rin namo. Pag kuman sa seminar, gamay rin akong na inumduman sa training nga ilang gi tudlo rin namo. Munang ibuhat ko buta nga makakuha gi ko sa proper training o makakuha ko guide kung saan pag-training ang boxing. Ito niyadto ko sa hagna, diskarte ko, niyadto ko sa hagna, o nipalit ko, kanang gitawag na ito, o kalamay. Akong gihatag sa mga trainer, niya, nangayo dahil may guide nila, o kung saan yun katong routine yun, saan pag-training o boxing.
Coupled with a Philippine team experience of Banal, his co-trainer in the program, he was able to execute the proper training based on the manual. The Father Acelo embarked on a new chapter of his career. He now has the know-how to have a proper training. He now has a manual. He now has a partner with experience how to execute based on the manual. Equipped now with a proper training manual with Banal as his sidekick, the Acelo's path to gold in the highest meet could be realized. ...2018 school sports competition. The younger Acelo easily toppled opponents in the sports regional competition. He qualifies in the highest meet in Vigan, Ilocos Sur. However, the path to gold was uphill for him as he will meet the best in the country. With him as the last boxing contender to play for gold, representing the region on the first of Bohol, this uphill increases, as he was pressured to capture the first gold for Bohol and for his career. The province and the region celebrates his success, but that doesn't come with no criticism. Some people say that that was just a luck. Motivated to prove he is one of the best amateur boxers in the country, he bested every opponent in the next year of the 2019 Palarong Pambansa in Davao City, redeeming his name to those who still do not believe on his capacity. It was a back-to-back title for him. On the other hand, the older Acelo, Jermil, reaches regional as silver. The younger Acelo, Jericho, also grasps regional with silver. Their youngest brother, who thought to be more deadly than Jerwin, the most successful Acelo, was with deep heart lost life. Their two youngest lady siblings started to wear gloves in their elementary years and still continuing their training. Reaching this far was never a bed of roses. It is accompanied with problems. First, their mother, who is an avid supporter of his son's career, has a heart problem. Second, they were met with financial problems as they prepared for several meets. Third, they lost a brother due to suicide. Fourth, they have a far more inferior training facilities. Their passion to boxing helped them a lot. And their finances, and personal development. They receive scholarship from schools.
Ikan sa pag agak na ko niya grade 8 hangtod ni grade 12 ako na nag-shoulder sa tanan niya mga panginahanglan sa eskwelahan, tuition, mga project niya. Ako na tanan. Okay.
They were decorated with medals. It helps them build their house. It helps them to become disciplined persons. Their passion, at least, makes their life better. Today, the Asilos continue to live as a farmer, continue to go to school with all diligence, and continue to nourish their boxing career.